can scale that wall using my gift. Balduke has such huge tunnels beneath it. We can use my gift to reach higher areas. I'm sure it'll come in handy.
treasure chest!
Treasure chest!
there.
Treasure chest! In that case... Hit!
This moon is really high.
Leave it to me.
I wonder if there's anything up there.
Swift! A treasure chest! Treasure chest!
Treasure chest!
Let's take a break.
This is a really big room. Wait! Something's coming! Down here before. They sort of remind me of the ones in the Grimwald Nox, though. But how could that be? It's strange. had no idea all this was right beneath our feet. And I've lived in the city my entire life. That was a close call. I wonder what that monster was. It wasn't like the Lemuris.
You must leave the prison before the guards catch wind of your escape. I hope that one day we'll meet again.
Watch out for those guards. We can use our gifts to sneak past them.
Yeah!
Thank you. Thank you. See, so that's what happened in the prison. Anyhow, Adel, take a look at all this. I get that it makes it less conspicuous for us to be coming and going with people here, but I'm not especially excited about the whole hiding in plain sight idea. A bar, of all things. He might play the part of a quiet old man, but that Parks, gets the job done.
Yeah.
You really can't judge a book by its cover, huh? Well, I guess a bar is the perfect place for gathering information.
Nonsense. I couldn't have done it alone. Carla from Pendleton was of great help. And that was thanks to you, Adol.
That reminds me. Carla mentioned she knew trustworthy people who could staff the bar.
Is that so? I wonder who they are.
If I remember right, the bar manager was some guy. He should be here soon.
My word! Look at how gorgeous this place is!
Wow, it really is!
You must be Adol. And a doll you certainly are. You're even cuter than I thought.
A doll?
Oh, Dopey. Of course I didn't forget about you. Those biceps are quite simply ravishing.
Thanks, I guess.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Shantae. From here on, I will be your lovely bar manager.
He is something else, ain't he?
Maybe he's just what we need.
And I'm Yuffa. I'll be your hostess. I can't wait to start working with everyone.
She seems harmless at least.
Good. Now that we're all here, as manager, I wish to discuss the first order of business. Without one, a bar wouldn't be a bar at all.
And what's that?
My dear Adol, why don't you take a guess? Oh no, not quite. But we will do that after the menu's been decided. Give up? The answer is simple. What the bar needs is a proper name.
You're right, Shantae. A name is important.
Don't worry. I picked out a perfect name just for you, Adol darling. Are you ready for this?
I hope it's not something inappropriate.
I heard you travel quite a bit, Adol. But because of your predicament, you're no longer able to do so.
Oh, you don't say.
You're a flower capable of planting your roots anywhere, no matter how barren or harsh. And when spring arrives, a cute, robust yellow flower will bloom. Soon after, it becomes a fluffy cloud of little seeds that float into the wind on a new journey. You, my dear Adol, are a dandelion. And that's what this bar shall be called. I was aghast when Carla told me what happened to you. But I will do everything I can to help you float into the wind again.
Dandelion, huh? I like the sound of that.
You see, I was confident they'd be great. They're perfect for the job.
Yeah, I have to say, I was skeptical, but I think we'll be just fine.
I'm glad everyone's happy. By the way, Adol darling, I have a message for you from Carla.
Helping anybody. Not truly. All this time, I was either hiding behind the Pendleton name or the White Cat. That's why I decided to do something. Not as a member of Pendleton, nor the White Cat, but as me, Krisha. I'm doing this for myself. Thanks. I built the shop and picked these flowers all by myself. I wanted to give it a personal touch. And best of all, I can consult for my own business free of charge. Oh, it's nothing to be impressed about. Before this, everything I did was a result of a decision someone else made for me. But you're different, Adol. You travel on a road to your own destination. And if a road doesn't exist, you make one. Yes. I think you've inspired me to be brave. Like you, Adol.
Look, they're building something new here.
Are you opening a shop here?
Yes, ma'am. It'll be open for business very soon. I hope you'll all have a chance to visit.
What kind of shop is it gonna be?
It's already a lovely sight for sore eyes in this dreary part of town.
Thank you for doing this, Adol. It seems this is just what she needed to finally take that first step. She's a smart girl with so much potential, but she's too kind for a place like Pendleton. The company's success is driven by sheer capital and steep profit margins. There's no need for her to be forced into that kind of environment. It's merely a pragmatic observation. Despite her gentle nature and the fact that she's adopted, we're actually quite similar. Oh, I suppose I haven't told you. But whether or not we share the same blood is of little significance to me. I wouldn't treat her differently for something as trivial as that. It's business as usual for me. Father depends on my work at Pendleton. It's my duty as his eldest to inherit the family business, after all.
Interesting. So this is the adventurer Adol Kristin.
You're finally awake. As you can see, I'm a guard. I can't answer that question. Sorry, but I can't allow that. I'll bring you food and water, and I'll check up on you on my rounds. Don't try anything funny, okay? Even if you somehow get out of that cell, you'll never find your way out of the prison. Recently, some monstrum called the Crimson King supposedly snuck in. There was a big fuss about it, but we're safe here. No one gets in or out. We're in the most secure part of the prison, the special sector.
Bye.